what are the NEC 2023 updates pertaining to cybersecurity? Cybersecurity is gaining importance in power distribution systems. In your home, smartphones, receptacles, and smart breakers require protection from cyberattacks. The National Electrical Code has begun its journey to include requirements around this important topic. NEC 2023 includes updates in Articles 110, 240, and 708 that require an additional level of attention to cybersecurity. Let's look at the updates in each of these articles. Article 110, Section 110.3A, titled Examination, Identification, Installation, Use, and Listing of Equipment, requires the cybersecurity be evaluated for networked connected life safety equipment to ensure this equipment's ability to withstand unauthorized updates and malicious attacks do not stop it from performing its intended safety function. This requirement applies to all electrical installations. Article 240. Section 240.6 has a new first level subdivision D titled Remotely Accessible Adjustable Trip Circuit Breakers. Circuit breakers that can be adjusted remotely or have its settings modified remotely can have an ampere rating that is equal to the adjusted current setting. An additional requirement in this section states remote access can only be achieved by two basic methods. One, the circuit breaker can be connected directly through a local, non-networked interface. Two, the device is connected through a networked interface. Article 708, Critical Operations Power Systems, has two updated sections. 708.7, Critical Operations Power Systems, connected to a communication network and have the capability to control any portion, must comply with either of two requirements. One, it is limited to a direct connection through a local, non-networked interface. Two, a connection through a network interface must comply with A or B. A, the system and associated software are identified as being evaluated for cybersecurity and listed to UL 2900. B, a cybersecurity assessment must be conducted on the connected system to determine vulnerabilities to cyber attacks. This is not a performance requirement. It simply identifies vulnerabilities to cyber attacks. The assessment must be conducted at 5-year intervals. Documentation of the evaluation, assessment, and certification must be made available to those who are authorized to inspect, operate, and maintain the system. Section 708.8 requires that a commissioning plan be developed and documented. In addition, there is an informational note referencing 708.7, which implies that the commissioning plan must include a cybersecurity assessment. Visit eaton.com/NEC to learn more about the updated cybersecurity requirements.